Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to deploy schema changes to your Power BI model without actually refreshing the entire model. Stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date all the videos from both Adam and myself. Okay, Patrick, what are you talking about? Publishing changes to my model without refreshing the entire model? That's the only way you can do it. Well, no, it is not. I've been having this conversation with a lot of people. It actually came up in a session Adam and I were doing. It was like, hey, I've configured my model, set up incremental refresh. I have it refreshing. I have several years worth of data, gigabytes worth of data. And now I need to add a measure. I need to add a calculated column, but I don't want to completely refresh that. It takes me so long. That's why I'm using incremental refresh. Is there a way to do it? Absolutely. Using the ALM toolkit. If you don't have the ALM toolkit, if you go out to the website, you can find it. I'll put a link to it where? Down below, okay? So go ahead and get it downloaded and installed, then open up the desktop, open up the model that you created, and then I'm gonna show you how to do these schema only deployments, all right? So instead of all this talking, you guys know what I like to do, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So let's say you've created this model and you've configured incremental refresh. So you can see I have incremental refresh configured, and someone says, hey, I need to add a measure to this model. I need to add a calculated column, or I need to add another table or something like that. And just to verify, right? Just to verify that all my data is there, this model, you can see the model. If I live connect to the model that's deployed out to the service, you see that there's multiple years, not just 2020. You can see I'm live connected to the data set out in Power BI, which is the exact same data set that I'm using right here. And somebody says, hey, Patrick, I need this new measure. So what do you do? You kind of go, well, if I deploy it, then I gotta refresh the entire model, which could take a bit of time. So hang on, come back in a couple of days. Don't use that model anymore because it's gonna be out of sync and it's gonna take me a little bit to refresh it. And they go, what the French toast are you talking about? No. I need this pretty quickly because we got some end of the month reporting coming up. And you go, oh, wait. I remember Patrick did a video. He showed me how to do it. So let me show you. The first thing you need to do, like I said, is download the ALM toolkit. If you just go out to the internet, use your favorite search engine of choice. And if you just type in ALM toolkit, you'll see here's the homepage and just click download, download latest version. And then once you do that, it'll appear in external tools. Click on external tools, it's gonna open up. When it opens up, you'll need to go out to the service where you have deployed your data model and go to that workspace and however you normally go grab your endpoint, go grab your XMLA endpoint because you're gonna need it. So once you have the endpoint, you paste it in right here. You can see at the top, you can connect to the other data sets, you can connect to a BIM file, but I'm connected to my local Power BI desktop and I'm connected to my endpoint. You click okay, it may require you go through a series of authentications. So I'm gonna go ahead and get authenticated. Once you get authenticated, it's actually gonna run a schema compare for you. And what you'll see, let's go ahead and maximize this out. There's no difference in my schema right now. So they say, hey, we need this new measure. And so they say we need gross profit margin percent. So let's go over to our model and I'm gonna add a new measure. So click new measure and we go ahead and paste it in there and bam, voila. All right, and then we'll head over to the ALM toolkit, there's an options button. Always go here, get this options button. And what I want you to do is make sure that process is an option is set to default. There's other options there, but be sure to choose default. Always check this table. I like to check this table because sometimes there's other tables and other things that it'll pick up and try to process, even though I haven't touched those tables. So I like to choose this process only affected table. So it only processes the tables that I actually need to change. All right, back to my laptop. And then I like to choose this one because if I don't need to change any data, this four table updates retain partitions. And when you're working with Power BI has these refresh policies when you set up incremental refresh. This is more specific to Power BI, but when I'm deploying something that where I don't need to process, bring new data into my partitions or affect the schema of the partitions, I choose this option also because I'm minimizing what's going back to the data source and what's actually being processed on the model. So I click okay. And then it's got to do another compare because I've changed some things, let it finish the compare up. And then what you can do is you can actually hide some objects and things that you only want to see in this section right here. So I can say hide the things that's not affected, skip them. So I only can see what's actually affected. I'm gonna add this new measure over here to this service, to my data set in the service, all right? But I'm gonna just show everything back. You can go play with those and test those out. The next step is you have to click validate. Validate's gonna say, hey, this is what I'm about to do. So I'm gonna click okay. And then all I'm gonna do is click update, right? And then say, are you sure? Now you need to make sure on your capacity for the XMLA endpoint that you have read, write, enable. And so how do you do that? You need to be a capacity admin, go over to your capacity, click on that particular capacity, and then go to workloads and scroll down and look right here, XMLA endpoint, and set it to read write. Make sure you've done that. And then we're gonna choose yes, and watch this. Boom, just like that, it's done. It didn't read the database, it didn't do anything to analyze the services to my semantic model, just deployed out the schema. Let's verify this. So let's go over to the one where I'm live connected to the data set. You can see I only have 3 measures here. I'm just gonna click refresh. I'm waiting anxiously. Whoa, that was fast. Let's copy this card and let's drop this new one into the value. And wow, there's the data, just like that. I could format it up if I need to, but there you go. I didn't process partitions. I didn't reach back to the database. All I did was a schema only deployment using the existing data that's out there. That's the first thing you can do. Deploy measures. It's a piece of cake. But then somebody comes and says, hey, Patrick, got something for you, buddy. I need to add a calculated column. And I know what you're thinking, right? That's a row by row operation. So maybe I need to bring the data back in. Not really. Unless you've added additional data to your partitions or you've added additional data to the tables, yes, you'll have to process. But if the data that's out there, it's okay, and you just need to do whatever incremental refresh normally needs to do, then all you need to do is accept, just check a few boxes or uncheck a few boxes. Let me show you. Let's head back to our model. And what I'm gonna do is say new sales, and I'm gonna add a column. And we're gonna call this sales order line total. And we're gonna say this is my sales amount plus freight plus tax. So that's my new calculated column. And what I'm gonna do is head over to the ALM toolkit, and I'm gonna go to options. Let's not compare yet. Go to options. What we're gonna do is we're gonna make sure we check this, right? Because I don't want it to reach back to the database or affect my partitions. I'm gonna choose default and make sure you always check process only. Very similar to what you did with the measure. And then I'm gonna do a compare. Exciting, exciting. Hey, there's the difference. There's the difference. So if you click on this green right here, it'll show you, hey, there's an addition. Patrick's adding something new. And then I'm gonna go ahead and validate this. So it's saying, hey, I gotta update all these partitions. Don't worry. So what I'm gonna do, just to give you a little bit of confidence, I have the profiler running against my SQL server. So I'm gonna clear this out and I'll bring it over after I do this update, just so you can see exactly what's happening to the database. I'm gonna click update, say yes, it's doing something. Oh, it does say processing. It did process, but actually I had the profiler running against the database. Nothing happened to the database. So now I'm concerned, right? So let's go to my Power BI desktop that's live connected. I'm gonna do a quick refresh. There's my column. Click in the white space. Wonder, did it add my data? Boom, it added my data. It didn't reach back to the database because I checked that box and maintained my partitions. I don't need you to reach back to the database to go and get new data because my data's fine. When I run my normal refresh in the Power BI service, go ahead and do whatever you need to do to bring new data in for whatever I've configured, my policy that I've configured. But beyond that, I don't need you to go back to the source because what I have in my model is perfectly fine. That processing, what you saw, was a processing on the analysis server, on the Tableau model behind the scenes. It did a process calculate. One of the operations of process calculate is to create those calculated columns. That's one of the items that it does, all right? So now we got a bigger request. We got a bigger request. And they said, Patrick, I need to add a new column to my fact table. Doesn't exist, not a calculated column, an actual column. And I need to add another table. And I'm like, ah, in this case, it does absolutely need to process every partition in that table because it's got to reach back and grab the column, right? That new column has got to grab the data for that column, and whatever new tables that you pull in, it's got to reach back and grab the data for those tables. And more importantly, it's going to do a process calculate because it's got to create that relationship, and part of that calculate is where it creates the relationship. Like I said, there's calculated columns, relationship, and some other items. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So let's head back over here to this model, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to transform, and I'm going to go to my sales table, and I have a step here where I remove some columns. So I'm just going to click that step. We're going to add the promotion key dimension. And so we're going to click OK. And then what we're going to do is we're going to choose recent sources, and we're going to add the promotion dimension. Let's go find it. Dim promotion right there. click okay. And then what we're gonna do is click close and apply. Sure, import. I'm getting a little ahead of myself and click close and apply. And so what Power BI is gonna do, it's gonna use my refresh policy parameters and pull the new data for the sales table. Sorry, it was pretty fast. And then pull my dimension in. Gotta make sure it created the relationship. Let's bring promotion over so you can see. So it definitely created the relationship. So then we'll head back over to the ALM toolkit and we're gonna do some options here. And so I don't want it to retain. I unchecked that because I needed to process those partitions in the affected table. I needed to reach back out to the source and pull that data in. I also needed to process that dim promotion, and that's why I have it set to process default. So any tables that's been modified, it should pick it up. Most importantly though, I also said, process only affected tables. That way it's only gonna process the two tables that's affected. Let me show you. All right, so we're gonna click okay and do a quick compare, and you'll see, right, if we go here and say hide the skip objects, we're gonna say it's adding dim promotion. It's gotta add something to my sales table, my new column, and then here's my relationship that it's gotta create. And so we're gonna choose quick validate, and you can see, hey, it's saying, this is what I'm gonna do. What I'm gonna do over here is on my SQL profiler, I'm gonna stop just for 1 second, clear this out. I guess I could have just hit pause and stop. And let's see what actually happens when I push this out. So we're gonna click this, we're gonna choose quick update, say yes. While it's publishing it out, you'll see it's saying, hey, I'm doing some processing. And so actually what it's doing is it's reaching back to the database and it's saying, I need the data for dim promotion. It's gonna pull the data in for dim promotion. And then for each one of my partitions in my sales table, it's actually gotta reach back and pull that data in. I missed the one for dim promotion, but it's starting the process. Each one of my partitions, you can see here's 2017, here's 2011, 2015. So it's processing each one of my years. And then somewhere in here, you'll see the months, how to start doing the quarters and months for 2020. At some point, it'll mingle them in here. So you can see right here, right? There's a quarter for 2020, all right? So it's all done. Now let's head back over to the model where I'm live connected. Let's click refresh. We should see a bunch of things happen over here. All right, that's nice. So there's my promotion key and there's my dim promotion. Let's drag this up. Let's click in the white space and let's go ahead and choose the English promotion name. I didn't do any massaging of the data. Look at there. That's all of the promotions. And let's see if the relationship was established. There you go. Just like that. It did have to process every partition in the table. And so if you have lots of data and you're adding a new physical column with the relationship, that can take a bit, but it's easier than trying to process the entire model because you may have multiple fact tables that have a significant amount of data. A more meticulous approach where you're doing one partition and one table at a time, you can use Management Studio to connect to the model, and then you can process each individual partition using some XMLA. You can process each table individually if you want to, or each partition individually. All right, what do you guys think? I'd love to know who's using this, who's not using this, who saw this for the very first time today. You guys know how I like to do. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.